Hello, this is Mike from ZSA, and today I'd like to take you on a tour of the Voyager's default layout. We're going to begin with actually how to get to the Voyager's default layout. So from Oryx's homepage here, you can just go ahead and click on the Configure button by the Voyager, and it will take us to the default layouts page. And you can also always navigate there by going to this URL, so configure.zsa.io/voyager/layouts/default. Pretty simple. Now, I want to start off by saying that this default layout is not meant to be the ultimate optimal Voyager layout. This is meant to be a good starting point that helps you get acquainted with the board's layout and some of Oryx and the board's features, but it's not meant to be like the perfect layout for you because everybody's layout, everybody's needs are a little bit different. So we think the most important button on this page is going to be the Modify Layout button where you can start tweaking things for yourself. To start the tour, I'm going to come over here and click the Play Layout Tour button. And now that we're in the tour, I can either navigate by clicking on Next and Previous, or I can actually use the arrow keys on my keyboard where I use right and left arrow keys to move through the steps. So let's begin. The first thing I want to talk about here are dual function keys. You'll see these in several places across the Voyager's layout. And how these work is that they have one function when they're tapped quickly and a different function when they're held down instead. So for this first key, you can see that when tapped, it sends space because you usually just tap a space key. And then if you hold it down, it's going to switch us to a different one of the board's layers where we can access some media control keys, among other things. I'll talk more about layers in just a minute, but for now, just know that dual function keys like this are quite important, and we have a couple other of them here as well. The next one is the other right thumb key, where if you tap it quickly, you get backspace, and if you hold it down, you get shift. Same thing for this key over here, where it sends apostrophe when you tap it, and shift when you hold it down. So there's a couple different shift locations on the board, and you can try out the different ones and see what feels comfortable for you. Another thing worth mentioning is that shift on our boards works just like you're used to. So if you hold down shift and then press 1, if I'm on QWERTY US, that's going to send an exclamation mark, but this will work exactly like your computer is normally set up for. So if you're typing in a different language, if you press shift and then a different symbol or a different letter, it'll work just like you're used to there. We do have dedicated symbol keys that I'll show in a little bit, but behind the scenes, those are ultimately just sending shift plus whatever is needed to send the symbol. Next up is caps word. This is kind of similar to caps lock, except you don't have to toggle it on and off. When you press caps word, it'll capitalize the next word you type and then automatically stop capitalizing things again afterwards. So this can be helpful if you just need to type one word in all caps or an acronym in all caps. I use this pretty frequently myself. Of course, if you prefer a traditional caps lock, you can always swap caps word out instead. Next, I want to talk about the board's thumb keys for a moment here. Since the Voyager is a bit of a compact keyboard, we try and put several different functions across its thumb keys by default, kind of optimized for that space. Our thumbs are generally quite strong and we have several thumb keys, so it makes sense to try and assign useful functions there. But if you notice that your thumbs are feeling a little tired out by so much thumb key usage, or if it's just not that comfortable for you, there's absolutely nothing wrong in moving some of those functions to somewhere else on the layout instead. Whether that's a different layer or just assigning another multifunction key elsewhere, you should try and do whatever's most comfortable for you. That's definitely number one. All right, now this particular dual function key here sends enter when we tap it, and if we hold it down, it'll switch us to the board's layer one. So now is a good time to talk about layers. This is specifically called a momentary layer switch, which means that when I hold down the layer switch, it's going to change what all the keys on the board do for a moment while I'm holding it down. But if I let go of that momentary layer switch again, it's going to move us back to the base layer again automatically, kind of like the shift key on a regular keyboard. There are some other types of layer switches as well, but we're not going to talk about those in this layout tour. We have some blog posts about those if you'd like to learn more, and you can also just experiment right in the Oryx configurator as well. So if we hold down that layer switch key, it'll take us to layer one. And the first thing that we'll see here on layer one is a full set of function keys. On this default layout, those go from function 1 to function 12, but you can actually assign up to function 24, I think. Let me double check my notes here. Yeah, function 24, if you want to, you can assign those to your layout. Also, you can see some of those dedicated symbol keys I mentioned before. So you can type shift plus 1 to send exclamation mark on a QWERTY keyboard, but you can also just press this exclamation mark key on layer 1. Accessing this is a little bit closer to the home row, so you don't have to stretch your hands as much, and so it can be pretty comfortable. Same thing on the other side for this number pad. When you hold down that momentary layer switch on the left thumb key, all of a sudden you'll have a full number pad right by your right hand's home row position, which can be very comfortable indeed. Now, both these symbols and the number pad can take a little bit of getting used to. That's a different location than you're probably used to for sending these keys. And our live training tool actually has some dedicated modes that are focused on training with symbols and numbers, so we definitely recommend giving that a shot. This can be a good deal more comfortable than like reaching and cording your hands with different keys to send numbers or symbols, so worth trying out. Next, we're going to go ahead and move to the board's layer 2. Its layer switch, if we go ahead and move on here, you can see that its layer switch is on the right-hand side's thumb key instead. And on this layer 2, you'll see we have some lighting controls, as well as some media controls and navigation keys, as well as the board's reset key. For these lighting keys, this first one, toggle lighting, will turn on and off the board's default lighting. So that's the built-in RGB animations or a solid color, basically anything that you control from the board itself. This next key, called toggle layer colors, will turn on and off any per key or per layer lighting that you've assigned to the layout in Oryx. There are a few other lighting keys on this layer here, some to allow you to switch the animation or pause the animations, turn up and down the brightness. There are a few keys that let you set a solid color for the whole board, but we don't specifically talk about those in the tour here. So next, we're going to move on to the media keys. This first one, you can see there's play pause. This actually will function to both play and pause by tapping this single key, where the stop key next to it will actually stop the media playback altogether. Above these keys, you can see we have volume up and down and a mute key, and then there's also previous and next track keys as well. On the other side, you'll see the board's arrow keys. So these are also located very close to your home row position. So you'll hold down that momentary layer switch on your right-hand thumb key, and then all of a sudden you'll have arrow keys without moving your fingers from that home row. This is super comfortable. This is a little different than you might be used to, but we really recommend giving something like this a shot. It can be very, very comfy. Clustered around those arrow keys, you'll also see home and end, page up and page down, and then down at the bottom here, we have a couple examples of one-touch shortcut keys. So this one here for previous tab sends control, shift, and tab when you press it, and the other one next to it sends control plus tab. That will allow you to cycle through your open tabs in a browser, so it's a lot more comfortable than trying to cord and hold down multiple keys to send those. And you can create one-touch shortcuts like this for pretty much any shortcut you'd like. This is a really powerful thing as well. We recommend creating some of your own one-touch shortcuts for your most commonly used shortcuts on your layout. And you can also see these two keys have a custom label where they don't say Control-Shift-Tab, they say Previous Tab and Next Tab. And that's also a feature that when you're editing your layout, you can assign a little label to a key to help you remember what it does. All right, last but not least is the board's reset key. Whenever you need to flash a new layout to the board, you can either press the Voyager's physical reset button, which is along the top edge of the left half, or you can press this software reset key. This is not something you'll want to press accidentally when typing, which is why we put it here in this secondary layer, but it's just good to know it's there. You still don't want to accidentally hit it, so keep an eye out. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the tour. Now, again, I want to say that this layout, not meant to be the perfect layout. We'd really recommend you, if anything feels weird or silly or like it's not going to work well for your particular needs, please do change it. Tweak some things around, try things out, and see how it feels. Like this little blurb says, ergonomics is more than like how the keyboard looks, and it can take some time and experimentation to find what's going to work best for you, but we think that's super worth it. Something tailored to how you use a computer is just awesome. Now, if you have any questions, you can always feel free to email us at contact@zsa.io. We'd be glad to read your email and write back to you there. Cheers and bye-bye.